Welcome back to my channel, 5-Minute Economics, where I teach economic concepts in a span of just 5 minutes. Well, the topic for today is factors determining price elasticity of demand. Well, in case you don't know what elasticity is and its types, well, I've made a video on elasticity long time back. I'll attach its link in the description as well as over here. So have a look in case you don't know what exactly is elasticity and the various types of elasticity. Well, in today's video, I'll be discussing the factors which determine the elasticity, and it is going to be one interesting video. So yeah, let's get started. Also guys, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel so that we can hit 50k very soon, and do follow me on my Instagram handle, which is called 5-Minute Economics. So firstly guys, let me tell you what exactly is elasticity. Elasticity is the degree of responsiveness, how the quantity demanded changes in according to the change in price. For example, you know, if the price rises or price falls, how does the quantity demanded react to it? Now, when I was in school, long time back though, I used to always get confused between elastic and inelastic. But for you to not get confused, I'll tell you one simple thing to remember. What is elastic? You know, elastic band, you know, rubber band, something which is stretchable, right? So that elastic, something which is elastic, it means it can be changed. Whereas if something is inelastic, you cannot stretch it, it cannot be changed. So if you remember this, you will be, you know, it'll be easier for you to understand these points. Number one is availability of substitutes. When a commodity has substitutes, the demand is said to be elastic. If it doesn't have any substitutes, demand is inelastic. Why so? For example, Coke and Pepsi. For example, if Coke becomes expensive, people will switch to Pepsi, right? So the demand remains elastic because quickly we can move to the other thing. But when it has no substitutes, you know, for example, bricks. We need bricks to make houses, right? You know, without bricks, you cannot build a house. So if you have to build a house, and even if bricks are expensive, you have to use it, right? So its demand is pretty much inelastic. Okay, secondly, nature of the commodity. Now, commodity can be necessity or a luxury. Now, what classifies as necessities? We know food and medicines. Now, their demand is typically inelastic. Why? You know, maybe you are hospitalized and you've got some injury and maybe you need one particular injection. We can talk about maybe Remdesivir in COVID times. You know, it was so expensive. We all know that maybe one injection was costing 50,000. Yet for the survival, people were buying it, right? So its demand is pretty much inelastic. Similarly, food, we will want food even if it's expensive, right? So that demand is inelastic. But when we talk about luxuries, you know, maybe diamonds, if it's become very expensive, we might, you know, hold it and maybe buy it later. Actually, the other point also is in tandem with the second point. They both are interlinked, as you can say. Possibility of postponement. Possibility of postponement means if something can be postponed, you know, if it's become expensive, we will buy it later. That is typically for case of luxuries. We can obviously buy later, right? So that way our demand is said to be elastic. But for necessities, or you know, when we cannot postpone, what can we not postpone? So that's why I told you these two are in tandem with each other. Something which we cannot postpone is the demand for necessities. As any guest dictionary, we'll buy medicine after a few weeks. Oh, banda will be gone, you know, that person will be dead if you don't buy medicine. It's needed for his or her survival. So in that case, we cannot possibly postpone the demand, and that is why its demand is said to be inelastic. Moving ahead to our next point, which is proportion of expenditure or proportion of income spent. Now in cases, guys, now elasticity is less on which consumer spends a bit less fraction of his income, you know, like on newspaper, on salt, on purchase of matchboxes. Hardly some portion of our income is spent. So for that case, our elasticity is very less. Whereas elasticity is greater, that is, it changes a lot on things which it spends a huge amount. You know, for example, milk. Our monthly milk expenditure is quite a lot. So a change, a rise or fall in the price of milk will definitely affect its demand. Next, guys, uses of commodity. Now, if something has several uses, the demand is highly elastic. For example, electricity. It is used for heating, cooking, and lighting. So, you know, the demand changes. It's pretty much elastic. Whereas something which has some, you know, very less of use, or I would say only one or two uses. Now, whiteboard marker, only used to write on the whiteboard. Come what may, even the price rises, the price falls, the demand remains inelastic. Moving ahead, guys, to our next point, which is habits of the consumer. Now, habits definitely denote a lot of elasticity. Why? Now, smokers. We all know that smokers are habituated to cigarette, right? So, if the price of cigarette rises,
it's not like they will suddenly quit smoking rice because they are so much addicted to it. So in that case, the demand is inelastic. Similarly, maybe someone who is, you know, addicted or habitual of using a particular perfume. Why? Because, you know, that denotes my smell. That is my perfume, my smell. So even if the price of that rises, because I'm so used to it, I will still use it. So demand is inelastic. Income of the buyer. Now, high level of income people, you know, very high-end people, they are literally not bothered about the rise in price. So for them, elasticity is pretty low. Income is high, elasticity is low. For example, Ambani, okay, you know, we just speak about him and we know that he, if the price of BMW rises from maybe 3 crores to 3 crores 20 lakhs, it's not that he's not going to buy it. He doesn't, you know, it doesn't affect him because he's so rich. So very high-income people have to be not bothered about the rise in price, so their elasticity is pretty low. But for people whose income is low, definitely their elasticity is very high. Opposite things, you know, if someone, a middle class man, going to buy a Maruti car, a small Maruti car, and maybe its price rises, then definitely it will affect its elasticity. Next, price range. Now, I spoke recently about luxury cars by high-end people, and I also spoke about Matchbox Salt, right? So very highly priced goods or very low priced goods, you know, their demand is pretty much inelastic. Why so? Now, supposedly a car, let's talk about Audi. Audi is 3 crore. Okay, I'm just taking it as an example. And supposedly the makers of Audi make it a little cheaper and now it's 2 crore 80 lakh. Now, people like us, we won't suddenly go and buy that car, right? Because it's that expensive. So in that case, guys, the demand is pretty much inelastic because it's so high, even if the price falls, it doesn't become affordable very soon. And even if the price rises from 3 crore to 3 crore 20 lakh, it's not like the high-end people, the billionaires, millionaires are going to stop purchasing it. Next, moderate range. So yeah, and secondly, guys, very low. I also spoke about Matchbox and, you know, a newspaper. We hardly spend a proportion on our income on it. So, you know, even if the price of Matchboxes rise, it's not like we are going to not use it. We are going to still buy it. So very high and very low things, you know. For those, the demand is pretty much inelastic. But for moderate range goods, now what are moderate range goods? Like example, cooking oil. Cooking oil costs maybe 400 rupees a liter, and supposedly due to inflation now its price is 500 rupees a liter. Now that's a considerable amount, right? And if there's so much inflation, we will try to reduce our consumption of that particular cooking oil. So moderate range goods, the demand is pretty much elastic. Lastly, guys, time period. Now, time period, you will think, how will it affect elasticity? But think logically, guys. Of course, it, you know, has an effect on the elasticity. It is much more elastic in the long run and less elastic in the short run. Why so? Because in the long run, you know, there is much more time. We can add on things. There are substitutes available. But in the short run, we are forced to use that good. So it's pretty much inelastic demand. So these are all, guys, the factors which influence the elasticity of demand. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you so much for watching this. And I'll see you in the next video pretty soon.